గవర్నర్ శ్రీ అరిఫ్ మహమ్మద్ ఖాన్జీ, సహకరణం టూరిజం దేవస్వం వక్ఫ్ మంత్రి శ్రీ కడగల్పల్లి సురేంద్రన్జీ, నియమసభాంగం అడ్వకేట్ వికే ప్రశాంత్, ఆర్చ్ బిషప్ మొరాన్మోర్ బెస్లియోస్, కార్డినల్ క్రిమిస్, శాస్త్ర సాంకేతిక ఒకపెండే ప్రిన్సిపల్ సెక్రటరీ ప్రొఫెసర్ కేపీ సుధీర్, ఎన్సీఎస్సీ నేషనల్ అకాడమిక్ కమిటీ అధ్యక్షన్ శ్రీ టీపీ రఘునాథన్, కేఎస్సిఎస్టీఈ మెంబర్ సెక్రటరీ డాక్టర్ ఎస్సీ ప్రదీప్ కుమార్, ఎన్సీఎస్సీ దేశీయ ప్రోగ్రామ్ కోఆర్డినేటర్ సుజిత్ బెనర్జీ, ఎండ ప్రియపెట్ట సహోదరి సహోదరన్మరే కుట్టికళే నింగల్ ఎల్లవరుకం ఎండే నమస్కారం. ఇరుపతి ఏళామత్ నేషనల్ చిల్డ్రన్స్ సైన్స్ కాంగ్రెస్ ఉద్ఘాటన చేయాన్ ఇవిటే ఎత్తి చేర్నది ఎనికు ఏరే సంతోషముండు. మై డియర్ యంగ్ scientists and children, I am extremely happy to be here this evening in this important educational institution, and I feel happy to see the future of my country, the young scientists who are budding. And before I make my speech, I would like to compliment the government of Kerala for sponsoring this event here, and also I would like to compliment the Archbishop of Trivandrum for giving this premises for the holding of this historic Young Child Science Congress. I am really delighted to be present here at the National Children's Science Congress, the flagship program of the National Council for Science and Technology Communication, Department of Science and Technology, DST Government of India, in collaboration with the State Government of Kerala. I understand that the primary objective of the National Children's Science Congress is to make a forum available to children, both from formal, informal school systems, to exhibit their creativity and more particularly their ability to solve societal problems using science. I am happy to note that the theme of this Children's Science Congress 2019 is Science, Technology, Innovation for a Clean, Green and Healthy Nation. Clean, green and healthy nation. If you are healthy, you can become wealthy, but not vice versa. If you are wealthy, there is no guarantee you will become healthy. So first of all, we must create clean, green environment, and we must all try to first love and live with the nature. Nature, culture, together for better future. That should be our mantra. Let me repeat, nature, culture, together for better future. Future of yours, future of ours, and future of the country. The nature has been very kind to us, and particularly I am in Kerala, the God's own country, beautiful nature. We must preserve that nature, preserve that culture, the beautiful greenery, the beautiful greenery, and always ever-flowing rivers and water bodies, and the bright sun, not our sun, but the real sun, and then the moon, and also the boon of knowledge that is given to us. If you use it properly, if you add beauty and duty, you can become mighty in future. That has to be understood by all. I was filled with joy to see the young and igniting minds of India who have gathered here to showcase their small but significant research activities. My best wishes to all the participants who are taking part in this event. The innovative mind of the youth is the most powerful resource of the earth on this knowledge era. We are living in a knowledge era. Knowledge is the biggest investment, and we, India, which was known as Vishwa Guru once upon a time, students from across the globe used to come to India, to Nalanda, to Takshashila, to Pushpagiri. Even the Chinese historians, Pahian, Yuan Song, they came and wrote about India and its greatness and its knowledge. We have the invaluable treasure of creativity and imagination with you. You should draw inspiration from the words of former President Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam, who had said, "Dream, dream, dream. Dream high, aim high, work hard. If you only dream without aim and without working hard, dream will be daydream, daydream only. So if you want to become the daydream into a real dream, you have to work hard. You must aim high. Definitely you will climb high. Dream transforms into thoughts. Thoughts result in action in the ignited minds. I was informed that around 658 child prodigies from 28 states, 9 union territories, 15 various Indian schools in the Middle East are participating in this event. Dear children, historically India has been a lighthouse of knowledge. Our Ayurveda system of medicine can be traced back to 5000 BC. Indus Valley civilization had irrigation and sewerage system as far as back as 2500 BC. By 200 BC, South India was making high quality wrought iron, and of course the invention of zero and the contribution to astronomy are well known. Let us look at some of the invaluable contributions made by our ancestors. Aryabhatta's Aryabhattiyam is considered a seminal work. Equally pioneering work is the Panchasiddha Kantika of Varaha Mihira. Of course, Charaka and Susruta are known as fathers of surgery. Rishi Kanad, the first, spoke of Anu, atom, as an indestructible particle of matter of Kannada Sutra, while Patanjali is considered as the father of yoga. You are innumerably legendary scientists of ancient India who have enriched the thoughts. They have given the thoughts. You must do research, study, and see to take the thoughts forward, to have the imagination to become the reality of the nation. We need to take pride in their achievements and share the knowledge we have inherited from them with the entire world. India's contribution to science in modern era is also significant. In early 20th century, Professor Satyendranath Bose, Bosan, Professor Subramanyam Chandrasekhar Limit, Sir C.V. Raman's Raman Effect, and Professor Jagadish Chandra Bose wireless communication have earned global recognition. As a matter of fact, there is no dearth of talent in India. The only thing required is to create the right ecosystem for innovation to thrive. The Children's Science Congress, an important event of the Indian Science Congress, is organized to provide a unique opportunity to children in the age group of 10 to 17 years to use their scientific knowledge and know creatively address the problems identified by them. Students must be made aware that the real purpose of science is to make people's life comfortable and happy. What is the purpose of science? What is the purpose of research? What is the purpose of technology? The purpose of technology, research and science is to make people's life more comfortable, more prosperous, more happy. How to bring happiness? That is the purpose of science. New inventions, new interventions, incubation, innovation, all these things are very much required. Make in India, Skill India, Digital India, Clean India. All these programs are aimed at making our nation a healthy nation so that we can become a wealthy nation. And then with the science and new technology and with the governments doing their best, you can make wealthy nation into a happy nation. That should be our effort. That is our mission. This is a mission for with passion, not for any commission. Nobody should do any omission nor give any remission. That should be the passion to move the nation forward in the world. That will be an ideal situation. My dear youngsters, take this as a mission. Science, technology, research, innovation. Come out with new ideas. This land is very fertile. The young minds are very brilliant. If you give them opportunity, The conference idea is to bring them together, to make them to exhibit their talent and also to understand others' talent, to learn from each other's experience and then move on. That is the purpose of this Children's Congress. You are all here. You are gathered here, I am told, for 4 days. You might have exchanged ideas. You might have seen the others' knowledge. Be open, be innovative, and then always try to find out something new while not forgetting the old. Old is gold. That has to be understood by all. Students must always remember this. This is important to inculcate scientific temper in our young minds, which will go a long way in the technological progress of this country. Scientific temper is very much required. We must understand the advancements in science and technology, and innovation will be of no use if they remain in laboratories. If the innovation is confined to lab, it will not serve any purpose. So, lab to land, that should be the focus. And India, basically an agriculture country. Agriculture is a basic culture. The agriculture is in distress. We must come out with new ideas, how to improve agriculture, new methods, how to minimize water usage, how to produce more crop, per drop more crop, reduce, reuse, recycle, and how to preserve and conserve the resources that are available, and also how to add value to agriculture, how to have food processing, how to move on to allied agriculture activities, because even today 60% of our people, they still live and depend on agriculture. So the science should focus more and more on agriculture. This is my appeal to all younger generation, because agriculture is important, industry is important. Agriculture and industry and business, they are like two eyes. Both are important. Agriculture is important, business and industry is important. So we have to, and agriculture is unorganized. Agriculture is unorganized. So we have to focus more on the unorganized sector. All research and innovations must go beyond labs and try to solve the problems faced by the common people. Events such as these are important to encourage students to develop prototypes, projects, and models on aspects such as renewable energy, pollution, and cleanliness. We have a bright sun. All the time we never utilize that brightness. Sometime back, my dear youngsters, I was in London. The driver who was driving my car, he said, "Sir, good morning." I said, "Okay, namaste." He said, "Sir, today is a sunny day." I said, "Is it your son's birthday?" He said, "No, sir, sunny day. Sun is very bright." Then I told him, "Poor fellow, in India, 365 days are all sunny days." But we never thought of utilizing the sun. Now we are going for solar. We are going for renewable energy. We are going for clean energy, which we have neglected earlier. Now we are leading the solar alliance. We have reached almost 200 gigawatts. We still have the potentiality to move on. This is an area. Rainwater harvesting, this is an area where the research must be much more, how to make it very simple. That has to be understood by one and all. And then, how to control pollution. Pollution creates tension. If you have tension, you cannot pay attention. This has to be understood by all. So the pollution has to be controlled. Pollution has to be controlled. That is possible. One is renewable energy. Second is clean and green. And everybody following Swachh Bharat. Swachh Bharat is not a program of Narendra Modi ji. Swachh Bharat is for your body and mind, not for Modi. You have to understand that. This is a national program. Swachh Bharat, Beti Bachao, Beti Padao, per drop more crop, Fitness India, they are all meant for making India fit, physically fit. I would like to caution all the youngsters taking advantage of this conference on two aspects. In the recent past, non-communicable diseases are increasing. Communicable diseases are decreasing. We are able to control by medicine, by research. But non-communicable diseases are increasing. The international magazine says, scientific analysis says, the main reason for this increase of non-communicable diseases, including cancer, is change of lifestyle. Second, food habits. Our life is becoming sedentary. Sedentary. No physical activity at all. We must have physical activity every day. The boys and girls must go to the ground, or at least ground floor in the apartment. Do some exercise. Do some exercise. Physically fit. I am now 70 years. 70. I play badminton every day morning 1 hour at this age. Why? To keep myself fit. Today, I am making 2 air journeys to and fro, 3 helicopter journeys, and then 3 road journeys, all in one day. I was in Varakkala in the morning, Varakkala, for Narayana Guru, the function. And then later I went to that Satya Sai orphanage, and now I came to your program, and I'll be going back to Hyderabad. How I am getting this energy? One is, of course, seeing the youngsters. When I see you, I have more confidence. Future is bright. When I see your smiling faces, your confidence, I become more confident about the future of my nation. Second is the physical fitness and attending useful programs to give message to my future citizens of the country. So, my dear youngsters, make physically fit. Leave the sedentary life. Second one is, they said, the analysis, medical analysis says, second one is food habits. We are also eating junk food. Junk. Don't worry, I am not prescribing any food code. You can eat whatever food you want. Vegetarian, non-vegetarian, both together also or separately also. I have no problem. But eat good food. Eat proteinous food. This is what is lacking. If you go to hospital, check up yourself, and not only you, elders, everybody will be having some vitamin deficiency because we are not eating proper food, and some of us are eating, particularly children, junk food. This pizza and burger may be useful to them because of their seasons, their weather conditions. But India, it is not suitable. Some people say, sir, now it is instant food. Instant food means constant disease. This has to be understood by one and all. Food cannot be instant at all. Food has to be cooked properly. And you have thousands in this country, great advantage, thousands of varieties of food are available. I need not explain to Kerala people. You have appam, you have idiyappam, you have meenam curry, you have Tamil Nadu Vartu Kolambu, you have Andhra Chapala Pulsu fish curry, you have Kerala fish, what a beautiful and what a tasteful variety of seafood you get in Kerala. Your idli, your dosa, your sambar, your pongal, so many things, has no comparison in the world. Leaving those things, why should we run after other food? That food is suitable to them. Our food, our forefathers, our grandparents, for years together, they lived, they experimented, they enjoyed, and they prescribed to us. So we have to follow Indian food, Kerala food, and national food, rather than running behind others' food. What is good, that is a different matter. First, weather is important, and weather varies from place to place. Delhi, yesterday was a 2 degrees. And here, you need air condition. It is very heat. Different weathers, that's why different types of food also. Nowadays, we have developed a weakness. Youngsters, TV, advertisement, big advertisements, icons coming and saying, use that, use this hair oil, your hair will go. That is advertisement. My point is, when you have time-tested experience of your forefathers, why do you run after this advertisement? And business people, naturally, they try to make you advertisement impressive. They bring a menu card, go to a restaurant, menu card, chicken 65. The fellow age is not even 25. He want to eat 65 and become early 65. I'm saying it in a lighter manner so that it registers your mind. So these two things has to be kept in mind. One is physical fitness, second is eating proper food of your choice, whatever it is. The sanitation, the waste to health, ecosystem, health, hygiene, and all these things are important. Mahatma Gandhi said sanitation is more important than freedom. This is what Gandhi said. Sanitation is more important than freedom. And also innovation is required now. The Prime Minister has given a three-line advice. He said reform, perform, and transform. Transform the nation. Transformation of our lives is important for all of us. In the transformation must be led by the scientists, the budding youngsters. You have the ability. Create that stability and have the mobility. Then the nation can move forward by your ability and with your new interventions. Dear children, the world is facing the ill effects of climate change and global warming. We need not only need to find solutions, but also must protect and preserve our nature. I am happy to note that the scheme of this Children's Science Congress is science, technology, and innovation for a clean, green, and healthy nation. Dear students, science provides answer to challenging problems. Hence, science is education important for the development and growth of a nation. Scientific thinking involves curiosity, reasoning, and open-mindedness. The Science Congress is a platform for the young children to understand scientific principles and interact with scientists, raise questions, get answers, and develop a scientific attitude. We are living in an era of unprecedented technological change. This is an age of innovation and scientific temperament. From a young age will lay the foundation for innovative thinking. Science education will make children to seek the truth without any basis or without any bias or prejudice. It will make a children to rely on analysis, questioning, and reasoning before arriving at a judgment. Science and technology and innovation are key drivers of economic and social development. Science and technology and innovation can contribute to the sustainable and inclusive development. Innovative and appropriative technologies can ensure steady improvement in living conditions and ensuring rising incomes. In the global innovation landscape, India continues to be the most innovative economy in the Central and Southern Asia. India can make a true impact on global innovation in the years to come only with your intellectual contribution in innovation and creativity. Science and technology will be an important factor in transforming India into a developed nation. The young scientist minds assembled here represent a cross-section of the 300 million youth of the country. You should all be curious, acquire knowledge, core competence, determination, perseverance, and the courage to pursue your dreams for interventions and make path-breaking discoveries. You have a bright future. Some of you might be interested to go abroad also, little later. Earlier, I used to tell the people, no, stay back. But now you can go. We have enough population here. Go, but three-line advice. Go, land, yearn, and return. You must come back to serve your motherland. That is your duty. Mother tongue, and motherland should never, never be forgotten. The mother who has given you beautiful birth. Mother includes father also. Woman, W-O-M-A-N. Man is there in woman. Second, the place where you were born, Janma Bhumi, should never forget. Third, the mother tongue, the language that has come from mother's womb, the Malayalam, or the Kannada, Telugu, Tamil, Marathi, Assami, Punjabi, Bhojpuri, Kashmiri, Dogri, Urdu, any language, you should never forget that has come from mother's womb. Mother tongue is like your eyes. Other language is like spectacles. If you have eyes, spectacles will work. If you don't have eyes, even if you wear ribbon, nothing will come out of your zuban, tongue. So first, try to promote mother tongue. Try to speak in mother tongue at home. Try to think in mother tongue. That is what is required for a country. because of colonial mindset, because others came and ruled us, they changed our minds and they ruined our minds also. We have started neglecting our culture, our heritage, our language, our dress and other things. I'm very happy I'm in this part of Kerala, while people, even now, the youngsters, they follow the age-old traditions. By changing dress alone, one cannot become great or very important. The journalist asked me after I became vice president, they said, "Sir," I said, "What?" "Now you are vice president." I said, "Yes, I know." They said, "Sir, what about the dress?" I said, "What dress?" "Vice president, sir." That means, in their expectation, vice president means that suit, boot, hat and coat. I said, "No change of dress, but only change of address. That's all. I have not changed my dress. I go to international conferences. Recently, I was there in NAM conference, non-aligned movement. Out of 120 countries, I was wearing my own this dress. Simple. People are happy. Nobody looked down. You will be estimated by your character, caliber, capacity and conduct and contribution, not by your dress. This has to be understood by one and all. The youngsters must remember this. And then motherland, the country which has given you beautiful opportunity, Kanyakumari to Kashmir, Attack to Katak, irrespective of caste, creed, sex, religion and region, India is one, one nation, one people, any problem. There is a Kerala flood in Kerala, entire people including Kashmir, they should think about Kerala. If there is a problem in Kashmir, the entire country must think about Kashmir. That is the Indianness, that is the Bharatiyata. We have different languages, we have different dress, different language. We have more than 760 languages. There are more than 1,000 also. Some of them are slowly declining. But we should all first promote mother tongue, then learn other languages, including English also, Hindi also. If you want to read Chinese also, I have no problem. Persian also, no problem. But promote mother tongue first at home. Talk to others in the home in your mother tongue. Secondly, respect your motherland. Do something for that country. And last but not least, remember the Guru. Jo gyan dene wale, Guru ko hamesha yaad rakhna chahiye. The Guru who has taught you, you should never forget him. People may say, "Sir, what is the need for Guru nowadays? Everything is there on the net." Net or Google. Even if there is some repair in Google and net, you have to call a Guru. Understand the importance of Guru. Remember Guru forever. So Google can never replace Guru. This has to be understood by one and all. You may have different language, different dress, as I told you, alag bhasha, alag vesh, phir bhi apna ek desh. Vividhata mein ekata, Bharat ka viseshata. That is the beauty of this country. Unity in diversity. You have different languages, you have different religions, different regions, but we are all one, culturally one, nationally one. This feeling has to be developed with a scientific temper, with analytical mind, with innovative thinking, with your roots strong in our culture and heritage. You will be able to move faster, you will be able to make nation stronger, and that is what is the purpose. My best wishes for the success of the scientific pursuits, all the participants from different states. Let me also take this opportunity to wish you all a very happy and prosperous New Year, prosperous Pongal, prosperous Sankranti, prosperous other new festivals that are happening in this prosperous land. Let us all join together to remember the heritage and also work for others, because our culture, Indian culture, says Sarve Jana Sukhino Bhavantu Vasudhaika Kutumbakam. The entire world is one family. Share and care is the core of Indian philosophy. Share and care is the core of Indian philosophy. Share your knowledge, care for your brothers, and then work together for the nation. That's my appeal to all the youngsters. All the best. God bless you. Thank you very much. Namaskar. Jai Hind.
Thank you, sir.